Alrighty, here we go. So we are going to be doing a full self-driving beta video today. We're on 11.3.6. I just have to pull out of this area here because the beta is not great with parking lot type situations. It is a little bit rainy today, so I think this will be an interesting test. We're headed down to Ontario Beach here in Rochester, and this will be kind of a test in the future. So as new software comes out,
we can just keep going back to it.
We're just going to keep using this route. Yep. We're going to use it as kind of our main, our gauge of how things are going.
All right. Baseline.
So baseline. Yeah, baseline. Baseline.
What's that called in a control? This is our control test.
Yep.
Kind of tough starting out in the rain, but.
Just a little bit.
Oh, well. It's not raining too hard, so it shouldn't be bad.
So we're going to engage beta. We're going to go to, we're going to keep it on average for now. And, hopefully not have to intervene too much here. Let's see here. I think we should keep minimal lane change on or off?
Probably on.
Keep it on, you think?
Probably.
Let's see here. So we'll do minimal lane change. That way the car won't do speed-based lane changes and get us into really awkward situations. Get this wipers going a little
This
bit
intersection
here.
has been interesting. Seeing how far it'll get over.
Yeah.
It actually did it.
Okay. Oh my gosh. Okay. So it was going a little bit too fast there. I'm certain it would have stopped, but the other driver probably would have freaked out. So we're going to disengage there. Okay. If you're going to go. So I'm touching the accelerator right now because it was kind of close to that oncoming truck a little bit. So that's a rough intersection. There's a lot of blind areas and it's also rainy. So not to make an excuse for the beta. It definitely needs to be able to do that, but
yeah,
I did touch the accelerator there. Yeah,
I think the toughest part, because one of the unique things about that intersection is you're starting off on a spot that A, doesn't have any lines, and B, where the that was nice.
That was really good. So usually the car really overreacts in those situations. It did not overreact.
That felt natural.
That was very natural.
But it also, the road like opens up all the way across. So you go from a wall to having space.
Yeah.
And I think beta is trying to figure out like where the road is and
yeah,
where it's supposed to be, it's while also trying to take the turn.
Yeah. It's also over a little bit. Yeah. It's also over a little bit of a hill too. Yeah. So it's hard to kind of fully see everything.
And the trees are right there. Really awkward spot, but I think it handled it okay.
All right, this is a weird situation here, so we'll see what beta does.
Yeah, I wonder if beta's just going to pass all these cars and then realize, yep.
Yep. Oh.
Uh-oh.
Is it going to let... Oh, is beta going to take this? Oh, my goodness.
Wow.
It actually did it. Okay, okay.
Interesting start to the video.
That is really... There's a Tesla right there. Wow, okay, that was very interesting. That was fun to watch. Hey, let's make this full screen.
I know this is our first one, so we don't have any footage of this on the channel, but I feel like before 11, like before the current one that we're on, they would not have taken that gap.
Yeah, no, so it's, and keep in mind, this is on average right now. So from other tests I've seen on YouTube, the difference between chill, average, and assertive is almost nothing. It might even just be the Tesla engineers just, I don't know, like a sugar pill type thing, just messing with us. It might not actually do anything at all. So this left turn here, getting onto the highway, has been very tough for me. This is actually how I get to work. And there's a lot of traffic. This is a very like high traffic time. It's almost 5 o'clock. A lot of people are getting off work. I might actually have to take over here, to be honest with you, unfortunately. Let's see what happens. There's a lot of traffic. I have my foot ready to take over. For those of you who don't know, as long as you see the blue line, I haven't taken over yet. And of course, I'll let you guys know when I actually do take over. I'm afraid it's going to go here when there's not enough time to go. Yeah, there we go. Okay, it stopped. It's getting ready to turn.
Nice.
Okay.
Little steering wheel freak out there. But
That was actually really good. Oh, fantastic. Okay, so that's awesome. I'm usually too nervous to let it try to go there. So to be honest, I usually just disengage. For the sake of the video, I left it. And I'm actually glad I did. Beta's impressing me right now quite a bit.
Yeah, I think we picked a good time to go. There's just enough traffic that makes it interesting because obviously the most dangerous and interesting part of driving is the other drivers.
Yes, absolutely. All right, so One of the things that version 11 is really, really known for is waiting to the last minute to get over on the highway. And this, the lane that we are currently in right now ends in just a couple hundred feet. And I don't think it's going to do anything about it until it actually... Oh, wow, that was really loud. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
What was that?
It must have just been a rock.
So I just turned on the turn signal, and it is not going to... Okay, there we go.
It's not technically wrong.
Yeah.
But it feels wrong because normally you try to get out of the, like, on lane as soon as possible. You don't just wait for it to... end.
Right. That is very strange.
It leads to more danger than it needs to.
Yeah.
Like, you might as well get over.
It's an awkward situation. People don't know what you're trying to do, and it's weird. Do you see any cracks in the windshield after that rock? That was so loud.
I feel like it hit your door or something.
Yeah.
It's weird because the acoustics, like, one of the things from a normal car to a Tesla that you notice, like, right away is obviously the acoustics of inside. Like, even just talking, it just sounds so different because of all the glass. There's not as much dampening it. It's actually really cool. But definitely made that very loud.
That was really loud. I hope that was the glass, because if it was the paint, that's going to be a pain.
I have to have another service appointment.
Oof. Alrighty, so it's going to be taking exit 9A. I'm actually surprised with this amount of rain, and I'm probably going to jinx it here, but it hasn't given us that full self-driving may be degraded warning yet, which is actually a shocker.
I was wondering why we were staying in the passing lane, and now I know. It turns into an exit.
Yep.
Makes a lot more sense.
Yep.
I like in this version being able to see the arrows coming back at you.
Yes.
So you can tell. If you're not paying attention, you can tell.
Oh, would you look at this?
Ooh, we're going to have some traffic.
A high traffic situation.
I've actually never been in this much traffic with beta. I have no idea what's going
to
happen.
Yeah, I don't know. Here's minimal lane change turned on. Yeah, I don't want it to be trying to get through a bunch of lanes. I don't know why we. I don't know what we expected here going, trying to go to Ontario Beach. At 5 o'clock.
And there's a lane change, or a closed lane up ahead. But this is very interesting. I've never merged. I don't know if you have.
I've never been in this sort of traffic. I've used basic autopilot before I had the beta in this sort of traffic, just for stop and go, just so that I didn't have to constantly be touching the pedal. But let's see what beta tries to do.
It's interesting there. I didn't notice that before. But the line, like the stopping line, moved when the Prius just turned their brake lights on, and then it disappeared after it started going.
I'm gonna have to disengage here because there's some situations up ahead here, so I'm gonna have to start getting over.
Yeah, I think
the car does not know that there is that amount of road closure.
Right. Well, and also it doesn't get out of lanes quickly anyway. So
right, yeah. So what we'll do is we'll probably just cut here, and then once we get through all of this lane closure stuff. This is kind of one of those situations where the fact of the matter is beta just can't handle it yet. It will be able to. It'll have to be able to eventually, but and it actually probably can. I just want to play it extra safe here. We'll just see what happens. It's a very small stretch of road that is under construction right now, so we should be past it here in just a moment. I'm going to engage it right now. Well, let's see here. It didn't like the fact that I was engaging that while someone was merging in front of me. So let's see what happens here. So we'll turn it on.
It's interesting.
Giggles.
The occupancy network is like picking up a delay in each cone.
Yeah, it's version 11 has done that. What I've noticed the entire time. It's for these thicker like cylindrical cones.
Yeah.
Which obviously it doesn't have an asset for, so it's just showing a regular cone and then another thing kind of underneath it. At high speeds, it's like quite a bit off.
Interesting.
Yeah.
And you can see the guardrail. I think. I assume that's what this gray extra occupancy line is there.
Yep. Yep. It's definitely true.
And the wall, obviously. Now, this is always interesting to me. This yellow line pops up here when on the other side of a wall.
Yeah.
I don't know how it...
So because it's using AI, it's predictive. So it's predicting what's there. You know, obviously can't see it, but it's predicting it.
Yeah, it's interesting.
It's doing a great job right now in a lot of rain. I have my hand on the wheel because in the rain, Beta asks me to nudge the wheel very frequently. So I just kind of incessantly am just keeping my hand on the wheel. And but for those of you guys who aren't as familiar with how Autopilot Beta works, when the blue line is here on the screen and you see this blue steering wheel right here, the car is doing everything. The only thing that I can do and still have that blue line engaged is accelerate a little bit, which I will always let you know if I do that to intervene.
I think it would have just got to the end and then would have realized to wait.
It would have stopped, yeah. This is a pretty impressive drive though so far, honestly.
Yeah, a lot of good stuff right at the beginning.
All right, so we're taking this exit here. We're taking it pretty fast. But
slowing down gradually though, which is good.
Merges right onto a road where I believe it is 55, and then it goes down to a 35. We'll see here. And of course, it's going to do the classic waiting until the very, very last second to get over, because you know.
And AI. Not put a turn signal on, or
no? Why would anything? It turn? Yeah, why would it put a turn signal on? That would be crazy. Oh no!
Oh, yeah, yep.
One click.
After we were in the lane, yeah, that makes
perfect
sense.
After we were already
sense.
In the lane, that is absolutely hilarious.
Learn that from humans for sure.
Yes. Yeah, we need to train it less on human data if they're doing that. I don't know.
It was
kind of dangerous.
On that subject, I was listening to a podcast yesterday on like a tech optimist, and he was talking about how, especially with all these AIs coming out and ChatGPT and all that kind of stuff.
Yep.
How people want it to be better than them. Like, even if it reacts and does the same things we do,
yeah,
we're not satisfied. It needs to be better and safer. And so it's interesting. Because, like, back there, that's totally yeah. something a normal human would do. And we're both like, wow, that's so bad. I can't believe it did it. It's
well,
just an
I mean,
interesting, like...
You're definitely correct in that. I think in that specific situation, that isn't really something most people would do, to be honest with you. I think
right.
most people would turn on their turn signal and get out of that lane that they know is going to end. Because that lane is obviously designed for just being able to have some time to merge over onto the faster traffic, so...
Yeah.
But yeah, I know what you mean. It's one of those things where, you know, if it doesn't drive how you specifically would drive, it can feel like it's not doing something correct.
Yeah.
Or like you were saying, just not, if it's not even, sometimes even if it's not safer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And something they brought up, which I hadn't really thought about before, but as we move into more and more companies adapting and building their own full self-driving cars, down the road, we're gonna have choices, probably, that like certain brands are going to prioritize driver safety, certain brands are gonna prioritize pedestrian safety. Yep. Like inevitably, these are just gonna be decisions that these companies have to make, and then people are just gonna buy it based on their own moral beliefs
right.
and what they would like.
Right. So this is going to be interesting here. It goes down to 35 pretty quickly. I need it to start slowing down right about now. I just saw it, and it's slowing down fairly hard. I would have liked it to be a little bit more predictive about that speed limit using map data or whatnot. But this is where it's going to get interesting. We're going to have a left turn up here onto Lake Avenue, and yeah, there's a pretty good amount of traffic right now. So this will be interesting for sure. You ready to take over here, get into the turn lane?
Nice. Know exactly where we're going. Stopping for traffic light.
Yep.
Good. I love the update of being able to know what traffic light it's looking at.
Yes.
Super useful.
That is super handy.
Should be turning green soon. Green arrow.
All right, and no issues with the green arrow. very smoothly and confidently going through the intersection, exactly how I would have done it in this area.
Perfect.
I have the speed set to a 10% offset, so it's doing 33 and a 30. We're just rolling right through, and we are almost there.
Very centered, very calm. Absolutely. I do kind of wish that display-wise, we saw a green arrow, or it, like...
Yeah.
So we know that it knows.
Right. Right. No, it actually does show a green arrow if you zoom into the traffic light. Mm. It actually does show it, but it's not something where you can easily see
red, set
lines. Yeah.
This update is much better at displaying what it's thinking, though, which Absolutely. Is nice, because we can know... It feels like we know what it's thinking more and more.
Correct.
Which, I don't know, it makes me feel safer.
Yep, absolutely.
And I guess more importantly, you know when to take over because you know, oh, it's thinking the wrong thing.
Right. Alrighty, so I would say, coming up on this last traffic light up ahead, we got Abbott's Ice Cream on our left. I'm going to call that good. We're going to take over right here, and we're going to take it on home real quick. We have arrived, as you can see. Let's navigate home.
And good we'll trip. Just, we'll I went to a wedding there. Fun fact.
Oh yeah.
Yep.
That's all I'd say. It's a nice place for a wedding. Oh, maybe not.
Nope. Don't recommend.